there always is when we come to create, to make an album, some kind of progression. We've all done different things. You know, Stuart's gone away and done his work, and Andrew too, and Paul and I get on with our lives. I think that then when you come back together, you're bringing in whatever you've learned in that time, whether it's on, you know, whether it's a musical thing or whether it's something you learned about, just about life, you know? So it will always change and progress. I draw when I write songs is from my life and what I see and what I hear. Maybe that's why there's such a huge amount of time elapses each time when we come to make an album. You think I'd leave your side, baby? By Your Side came about from a lover's rock moment, like a reggae moment in the studio. And it was very spontaneous, you know, Paul's playing his bass, and we were just all in the studio jamming. And it just came about. A lot of the lyrics, even in a moment, just came from my head, you know. Not, it wasn't something that I was trying to root for, it just appeared. We call the album Lovers Rock. Traditionally, me and Stuart have often started songs on just guitar and vocal. And when I was younger, I'd listen to Lovers Rock music, which is a sort of soft, sweet kind of reggae. Oftentimes, he'll put a little reggae beat in, just the guitar, and I'll sing along kind of lovers rock styly. When I hear a beat like that, I feel lifted up and inspired. And also, because I'm not a lovers rock singer, I can sort of go somewhere else. I can go and become someone for a few minutes that I'm not, and sing in a way that I wouldn't necessarily naturally sing. We wrote and recorded as we went along.
We started at my place in London, then we went to Spain for about 3 months, and then we did the rest of it in this place in the country in England.
We still sound like the same band. I mean, we're recognisably the same group of people. I think that Lovers Rock it's become rawer, I think. I think everything has been unsmoothed out.
This album's a lot different from what we've done in the past. I think the instrumentation is a lot sparser. And we wrote the songs kind of all together, really, this time. It was like a real sort of feeling of the four of us all meshing together and doing something and working hard on it. And not that we didn't work hard on the other albums, but...
I'd say it's more semi-pro sounding. As in,
yeah,
we didn't
rougher.
We didn't really care about buzzes or noises. Yeah. Like, some of the vocals were done live in the studio, heard just singing with a microphone, so there's like... spill and stuff. I think it's cool.
I think it's more rootsy. It's more about the song. It's less about the surface and more about the roots. I don't have a particular favorite on this album. I think for me, it has a lot to do with the moment when I was writing and the atmosphere and the vibration and how excited I felt at the time when the song came to be. Sorrow is about a moment where you find in your bleakest moments, you kind of feel like you're the only person in the world who carries the burden, you know, the moment where you feel like everything's on your shoulders, but everything continues and you have to sort of face the world and continue as if everything's fine. It's a song for the people, I think, because we all feel that way. What am I supposed to do? Flows is a song that's about the atmosphere of how you feel when you fall in love, you know, the experience, chemical experience you have, and how you feel when you're really in love with somebody. I could